I remember rapping on the bus on the way to Sac State. It was like 2008, that's when I met Ugo K. We were barely getting started. We didn't know too much, but had to struggle so hard and somehow stay so tough. What's good and what's great or what's good enough? Just trying to push the limits and become someone. Become one degree, focus and achieve. Notice and believe, work and then receive. Leave the world better than we found it. But every day I'm constantly astounded. As I voyage through these troubled times, hate crimes, rates climb, stories making dateline, attacks in broad daytime on top of the pandemic that pushed our plans to the wayside. Not to mention these extra pounds on my waistline. No gyms, no classes, no extracurricular activities. COVID-19 canceling all my birthday festivities, but that's all right. It's a small price to pay when some have paid with their life. It's a small pill to swallow when someone's loved one died and they weren't even allowed to be at that loved one's side. I'm sorry. I know you're experiencing new levels of stress. I know you're feeling isolated and that's making you depressed. I know how careful you are to keep your gloves and mask on because you come home from work to your immune-compromised mom. I can see the way you've checked out. I understand your withdrawal. The last thing you want to do is have another Zoom call, hoping that the others don't hear your siblings playing through the thin walls. And you haven't had it easy. I want to say, believe me, I understand completely. And in some ways, I might, or maybe I never could, get how you navigate the world being misunderstood. I know how long you've been waiting to walk that stage and say you did it and have your whole family there to witness what may be your biggest accomplishment if it's not already. All these years you chipped away steady, overcoming obstacles, showing the world you could do what others said wasn't possible. I remember my counselor saying I wouldn't. At the time, even my grandma had doubts. I had to search deep within myself and figure out what I wanted to be about. I remember feeling like my voice wasn't considered, trying to figure out why it seems my burden was bigger, wondering if I'd just be written off as a quitter. Then Rondell asked if I'd drive a whole road only looking in the rear mirror. I can't worry what's behind me or all that I can't see, because the world will keep on going, and yes, so will we, and the sun will rise again, and yes, we will too. And though it may never be the same, one day this will be through. One day this will be history, a story we will tell of struggles that we face yet somehow still prevailed. So dreamers, keep on dreaming by any means. You are your ancestors' wildest dreams. You are the rose that grew from the concrete, the reason for someone's heartbeat, a beacon of hope where none seems to be, and now part of the 40-year legacy of 10,000 Degrees.